Hello, and thanks for tuning in. If you're new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button. If you're joining us back, thanks. It means a lot. Today we're going to dive into the 8-speed ZF transmission, commonly found in BMWs, Fiats, Dodges, most of your European cars ZF makes transmissions for. This one specifically is the 8-speed unit. I'll list the actual title of the transmission and the cars that it's in the description. So we're gonna start. We got to get the oil, whatever the 8-speed or 9-speed oil you have. I get a good deal on it from Mopar, so I stick with the Mopar brand. You can get the actual ZF brand as well, but you have to get ZF8 if it's an 8-speed, or ZF9 if it's a 9-speed. So we get however many quarts the factory fill is. They recommend, I think, 6, 7, 8, 9. I got 10 quarts. You need a roll of paper towels, fluid transfer pump, a 10 millimeter Allen, a T40, an 8 millimeter Allen, and whatever wrench combination you want to use to get everything off. If you have a power tool, it's great. It's better just to do it by hand. You have to have the filter and pan, which is in the box underneath it. That's a one-unit assembly. You can get an aftermarket one from Dorman, and I think you can replace the filter cartridge in it, but I don't trust it because it's 4 extra screws in the pan that can come loose while the car is driving, and these transmissions are supposed to be sealed for life only if there's an event where there's a need to change the filter. Like, this car had some cooling issues and some oil issues. The oil cooler went out, so it affected the transmission, and one of the transmission range selectors popped out. So the transmission ran a little hot, and I think it warped the pan a little bit. So always go back with OEM. It's the best, especially for these ZF transmissions. We're going to go under the car and look at everything that we have to do. Okay. We're underneath the vehicle on the passenger side. There's a drain plug here on the side of the case. This is the first thing you have to check if you can get loose. If you can't get this loose, it's game over. Take it to a mechanic, take it to a professional, because if you open the drain plug that's directly down underneath the sticker, and this is the 10 millimeter Allen, and this is the 8 millimeter Allen. The fill plug is 8 millimeters, the drain plug is 10 millimeters. If you drain this fluid and you can't get this plug out above it, it's done. There's no way you can get the fluid back into it. So make sure you can get this out. I broke that free, and it's not that easy. Trust me, I had to use leverage to get this free. I have this Allen key just for these types of transmissions so I can grab onto it with lock jaws and get it in there, and I'll be able to use leverage and push it and break it free, because they like to seize on there. So once you get that free, you gotta get the vehicle in the air. However you wanna do it, I'm not gonna show you. You know, you gotta get the vehicle all 4 sides up in the air, or if you're skinny enough, slide up underneath here. But we got it pretty even. So now we're gonna drain the fluid out of this 10 millimeter, and we'll be right back. Okay, well, underneath here on the bottom of the pan, again, this is the passenger side. It may be like this for multiple other vehicles. I don't know if there's a left side drain. This, like I said, specifically applies to a Dodge. We're gonna go ahead and loosen this, and as you're loosening it, it's gonna be coming out. You kind of want to look, see if there's any metal in there. The color is actually really good. If you can see it running. Light under here. That looks pretty good. Looks pretty good. We were scared because a couple times he went into gear and it wouldn't come out of park. So I don't see any really bad discoloration. The fluid is burned. The ZF fluid for this car is actually green. And as you can see, this is kind of like a dirty honey, I guess. So I think we caught it in time before there was any catastrophic failure. This will drain out for a while, so we'll come back after everything's all drained, and then we'll have to take all these T40 bolts that are on the pan off, and the pan will pop down. Alright, so you have a bunch of these T40 bolts that run around the pan. They are prone to strip, seize, break. A lot of the aftermarket kits come with it. Dodge, of course, makes you buy these individually. And these are, I believe, better quality than the OE ones or the aftermarket ones that they supply with these aftermarket pans. Luckily, I was able to get all of them out without stripping or breaking any of them, thank God. I like to get one corner of the pan off. You see everything's drained out, and then all these bolts are tight and loosened around, and I'll pop this corner off and drain the rest of the fluid out, and then we'll take the entire pan down after we remove all these T40s. Okay, so we removed all the T40 Torx head bolts, and this is the valve body. It looks, the fluid looked good. There's no hard staining on any of the casing down here. Nothing wrong in here. Everything looks good. There was no metal, just the minimal normal metal. It's 166,000 miles on this. Took a rag, just wiped down the outer perimeter of the gasket surface. There's going to be no need to add any type of silicone or anything to these surfaces. They are machined perfectly, and the new filter pan assembly has an O-ring that goes around this, so you don't even really got to wipe it with brake clean. It comes immediately super clean. So wipe everything down clean, and let's go look at those filters and see if there's any differences. Oh, also, forgot to mention, up here in this filler spot, that's where the filter pushes up in there. Make sure that the O-ring comes out with the filter. You don't want to have a second O-ring up in there, because then you'll have weak pump pressure and you'll destroy transmission. So make sure this bore is smooth and clean in there and there's no O-ring in there. All right, let's go look at the filters. Okay, we got the side-by-side here of the oil pans. This is a dealership one on the left, OEM. And it's the OEM one on the right as well, but from when the factory, when the car came off the factory line. You can see some noticeable difference immediately with the pan on the left. There's no drain plug, so it's an updated pan from Dodge. The pan on the right has the drain plug there. And if you look down on the bottom right-hand side, you see there's a drain plug right there. On the other one, there's no drain plug on the other one. So what we want to do is, we just want to inspect and make sure there's no metal in there. If you look at the magnets on the side, on the two sides, there's magnets, and on the back wall, there's magnets. That's normal wear that you see. And you see, if you go back over to the new dealership one, you see that the magnets are in there, they're clean. And like I said, the only difference is the drain plug's not there. Aftermarket kits sell like one filter kit that can be changed with four screws in the corners. I don't like that. Like I said, this is a sealed transmission. It was meant to be sealed by ZF and everybody else, so why run the risk of putting a screw in there that can come loose and get sucked up into the filter housing somewhere? We're going to go back underneath there. We're going to put the pan up, and then we'll start the filling procedure. The pan goes back on dry. Does not need to be lubricated. The O-ring doesn't need to be lubricated. It's actually... I believe called for the O-ring to go up dry. So let's get this thing back up there, torque the spec, you know, find your spec in the owner's manual, or not in the owner's manual, the service manual, or whatever the ZF transmission calls for, and we'll get it filled. Okay, we got the pan back up, and we tightened up the pan bolts to spec and the torque sequence for them to get on there. Make sure you just pop it in place and get everything lined up finger tight first. Now we're gonna start the fill procedure. At this point, you're gonna need a way to monitor the transmission fluid. It's got a temperature range. I think the sticker on this one said between 100 and 128. you know, to check the temperature. So basically it's cold right now. We'll fill it with about 1 to 2 quarts and it'll start to run out. That's when you have to put the fill cap back on it, start the truck up, and either monitor the transmission from the vehicle if it has a temperature gauge function or a scan tool that is capable of reading transmission temperature. So we'll get the trans filled up the best we can, start it up, and we'll be back. Okay, we started the vehicle. We got the initial 3-quart fill up of the transmission, and now we're gonna run it to about 100 degrees, take that fill plug back off, and start pumping some more fluid back in there. Okay, the trans temperature is 116. So as long as it's between 80 and 122 per Dodge's spec, we can go down and check it. Okay, when the transmission temperature is at the specified range, you're gonna back out the fill plug after holding the transmission in drive, neutral, and park for 5 seconds each. You'll pull the drain plug out, and if you have no fluid coming out, add fluid until it comes out. Don't go over the temperature range. If it has fluid when you pull the plug, it's good to go. Take it for a test drive. And we have fluid running out. That shows you that this transmission is full. We're gonna put the drain plug back on. Clean everything up underneath here. Make sure you don't leave no oil or anything, because it'll burn on the exhaust for a while and smell. And that's all it is to filling one of these ZF 8-speed transmissions and servicing it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.